Hey there, everyone. It's Mrs. D, and I am coming at you with my end of July update. If you found my videos interesting or helpful, please like, subscribe, and hit your notification button. Leave a comment and share. So let's take a look at July. I'm not supposed to like screen share our platform with you, I don't think. Otherwise, I would show this to you. But I'm really excited because I just calculated out the earnings in July. And there's so, like, I'm so excited. I smashed my want of breaking $1,000 a month. And I came in over $2,000 a month this time. And the other great, great thing about it is I only worked 41 hours. 42. It was like 41.67. So closer to 42 hours. And that equals $50 an hour. I was like, wait, what? $51 an hour. And that does not include the earnings that came in August 1st. Today is August 1st and it's a Monday. So a couple, like I had a 2-day camp and a 4-day camp that happened last week that started, they both started on Monday. So I received the earnings for those today. So they really were for July. That was another $178. So I'm just super thrilled with that. And I wanted to, you know, put that out there that there is hope. Now, I don't know how August is going to go because my kids went back to school. And so I'm more limited with what I can offer, especially during the day. And 8 unenrollments from Friday to this morning over the weekend, and only 6 enrollments. And a couple of them were in classes that were like, that are going to start in September or the end of August, but I still have hope, and that's okay. It's all right because I need to like calm things down a little bit, and I really want to focus on getting the organization going because that's going to be a lot more useful as passive income, which is what I've, you know, been wanting to do for a long time, especially because of the situation I'm in right now with my baby, which, by the way, sleep training, we finally got him sleeping through the night. We're struggling with naps, but he did just take a 30-minute nap by himself in his crib without like having a big temper tantrum before. So that's progress. I'm excited about that. Okay, so let's talk about Allschool real quick. And then I'm going to end this video. Allschool, I'm canceling all of my ongoing classes for several reasons. You cannot cancel when you can't make a class. You have to reschedule it sometime during the same week. So that really kind of stinks because I'm doing makeup classes on Friday and I like to keep my Fridays open. So my kids are back in school, so it's not a huge deal. But at the same time, like I would rather be able to cancel the week or add it to the end of the course. The other thing about ongoing is that you get notified when you get an enrollment, but you do not get notified when they withdraw. And that really stinks because you're going to class expecting to have 4 learners in there and there's only 1. The other thing I'm finding is that every single time I list the first class for them to be a little bit cheaper, they're only coming for that one class and then they're leaving. So there's no real interest in ongoing courses. They're just interested in getting courses for cheap. So my plan right now is to just use Allschool to fill in some of the gaps and create and just keep offering one-time courses. Because like the other thing is like I'm locked into a 15-week course with one learner. So I'm making $9 an hour for that one learner every week. So that's kind of not cool, but that's, you know, that's where we start. That's where we started on Outschool. That's where we have to start on Allschool. But the ongoing, it just needs more work before I can keep committing to every week doing that same thing for very little pay and having the parents take advantage of it. So you can list ongoing and not offer that first class discount, right? But then like, are you going to get any enrollments? You know, that's the other struggle. Anyway, I did make probably about $200 last month on Allschool just from those ongoings, the one-time classes and teacher recruitment. might be a little bit higher than that when you add in the teacher recruitment. But so all school, you know, it's still there. It's still an option. I don't think I'm going to list my org on it because there's like so much paperwork that's crazy to do for a platform that doesn't have a ton of momentum yet. So I might hold off on that for a little while and focus on getting it going on Outschool and getting another branch, that Christian branch of it created. So that's everything for the update for this video, and I will catch you next time. Like, subscribe, hit the notification button, leave a comment. I love you guys. Thank you so much for supporting my journey.